สวัสดีครับ Welcome to Phuket Extra brought to you by PSD Windows and Doors. I'm JP Mestanza and it's Monday, March 16th. We apologize for Friday's absence, which was due to technical difficulties, but let's get started with our top story. The Public Health Ministry is now reporting 32 new cases of coronavirus COVID-19 in Thailand, the biggest amount of infections in Thailand since the outbreak began, as Thailand now counts 114 people infected total. Among the newly infected persons are 17 people who authorities say were infected at pubs and boxing stadiums, as well as people in contact with others who returned from overseas. And officials are waiting on the test results of another 51 people suspected of infection. The tally has prompted Public Health Ministry to propose the closure of all entertainment places nationwide that have a high risk of transmission, as well as canceling all activities that involve large gatherings of people, although that would all have to be approved. Prime Minister Prayut Chan-o-cha mentioned the possibility over the weekend of moving to stage 3 for the country, the highest level of an outbreak in Thailand, which would be a full-blown epidemic, and would allow the government to impose a range of measures like setting up more hospitals specifically for people with mild symptoms, just to name one measure. The consideration of moving to stage 3 was made after an association of chest physicians called on the government over the weekend to do so, saying that Thailand is not equipped to deal with a drastic escalation in the number of cases. Globally, there are over 169,000 cases, just under 78,000 of which have recovered, and over 6,500 people have died. The Phuket News is continuing to sort through the various daily announcements, new figures, and planned measures for new arrivals into the kingdom amid the spread of the coronavirus COVID-19, and a lot of seemingly contradictory or incomplete information coming from some officials. But in the latest twist, officials here in Phuket say they will now check on all arrivals from Taiwan, Singapore, Japan, Germany, France, and Spain every day to monitor their health to make sure they are not infected. That's according to an announcement by Phuket Vice Governor Bijit Panapong. During the daily meeting of the Phuket Communicable Disease Committee on Thursday, Vice Governor Bijit said that all travelers from the 6 newly announced countries do not have to self-quarantine themselves, but when they arrive in Phuket, they must report where they will be staying, and he says officers will go check on them every day to make sure they have not developed symptoms of an infection of coronavirus. The vice governor did not say that the people coming from Taiwan, Singapore, Japan, Germany, France, and Spain have to fill out a T8 form to collect personal information, but he did say they have to report their whereabouts. Meanwhile, he repeated that all arrivals from the 6 risk zones of China, South Korea, Macau, Hong Kong, Italy, and Iran must self-quarantine themselves for at least 14 days, but it's unclear how officials will enforce it or if daily checks will be done by officials, and even if there are enough officers at all to check all of these new arrivals every day. The management team operating the Phuket International Airport, they posted a formal notice last week saying that people who pass through the 6 declared risk areas of China, South Korea, Macau, Hong Kong, Italy, and Iran must also present medical certificates to enter Thailand. Medical certificates are already being required for anyone coming from these countries, and now it will include passengers who are transiting through these countries when asked how it was possible while passengers were in transit to get a medical certificate that says they're virus-free. The general manager of the Phuket Airport, Mr. Tani Chuang Chu, replied to the Phuket News, quote, "That is the passenger's responsibility. My responsibility is to protect against the spread of the virus." The Phuket News has not heard from immigration officials or any other state entity that passengers from traveling through the 6 risk areas needed a medical certificate as well. Only Mr. Tani has said this. Phuket Extra, be right back after this. Welcome back to Phuket Extra. The outbreak of the COVID-19 coronavirus cost Phuket more than 15 billion baht in February alone and may cost the island up to 70 billion baht. That's according to expert analysts at the Prince of Songkhla University Phuket campus, Faculty of Hospitality and Tourism. The Associate Dean for Research and Graduate Studies, Dr. Chayanon Bucharuan, together with Vice President of the PSU Phuket campus, Pun Tong Chumnam, announced their dire forecast at a press conference on Thursday, saying that their research suggests Phuket will lose an estimated 32 billion baht in lost tourism revenues from these COVID-19 coronavirus outbreak. But they went on to say that further research shows that tourism revenues lost in Phuket can reach up to 70 billion baht from February through August altogether, while tourism business operators are the most heavily affected revenue-wise. The knock-on effect has spread to other types of businesses on the island, including retail, transportation, restaurants, and more. The economic impact for February alone is estimated to be around 15.6 billion baht, the experts say, with hotel operators losing 4.6 billion, restaurants losing 2.9 billion, and retail losing 2.6 billion. More figures can be found in the link to the story. Meanwhile, Dr. Chayanon says worst case scenario, if the virus is not contained by the end of April, the damage may rise to as much as 100 billion baht. Authorities are saying that there were no injuries in a fire that broke out at the Phaibun Sawadee Municipal School in Phuket Town over the weekend, although it did cause an estimated 500,000 baht in damages. It took firefighters half an hour to put out the blaze at the school located on Damrang Road in Phuket Town at about noon on Saturday. And luckily, there were no students inside at the time because of the Thai school break. The fire did start from the school shop and spread out, causing half a million baht damages, police say. An investigation into the cause is now underway. And that's it for Phuket Extra, brought to you by PSD Windows and Doors. For safe, secure, and soundproof windows, visit pvcphuket.com. If you're watching us on YouTube, click that subscribe button to check out all of our future videos. And if you're watching us on Facebook, give us a like on the Phuket News page. From all of us here at the Phuket News Center, thank you for watching. We'll be back tomorrow with everything you need to know. Until then, stay classy, Phuket.
คุณมองเห็นอะไรไหมครับถ้ามองไม่เห็นเดี๋ยวเราจะย้อนภาพให้ดูทีละมุมถ้ามองจากรถที่อยู่ด้านหน้าคุณจะเห็นชายขี่มอเตอร์ไซค์ตามมาด้วยความเร็วปกติถ้ามองจากคนที่นั่งอยู่ข้างทางคุณจะเห็นชายขี่มอเตอร์ไซค์ผ่านไปด้วยความเร็วปกติแต่ถ้ามองจากคนที่ขับรถตามหลังมอเตอร์ไซค์คันนี้มาติดๆไม่มีไฟท้ายก็เหมือนไม่มีคุณอยู่บนถนนตรวจสอบไฟท้ายให้ใช้งานได้อยู่เสมอ